So when you first turn on your VINNO ultrasound unit, this is the touchscreen that you'll see in front of you here. On the top right, you'll have all of your presets, and on the top left, you'll have the left, right flip, up, down flip, full screen, center line, T view, which expands the image, and any other optional features like contrast bubble imaging, for example. At the bottom, you'll have the most commonly used image adjustment parameters, so the frequency, the focus position, and the number of focuses. And then if you touch the little circles in the middle, you can get to the additional presets like V-speckle, gray filter, persistence, the various gray maps. And on the third screen, you'll have all of the other image optimization presets. So going back to the beginning, if you look in the bottom left-hand corner of the touchscreen, you'll see a little arrow. If you slide in the direction of that arrow, you bring up the main menu, which is where you can enter new patient details, select a body pattern, access the archive, create a comment for the image that's on the screen at the moment, end the exam, create a report, enter the system settings, or create your own presets for the applications. So if we first take a look at the new patient, the way to enter a new patient is just to use the touchscreen, and you can put in as much or as little information as you want to. So if I just type in new and then surname patient. Now if I wanted to start scanning, I can just click the tick button at the top there. But if I want to have a look at editing the patient ID or the secondary ID, I can do so here. Selecting the birthday, you can just hit the calendar there, and it'll bring up a calendar so you can select using the touchscreen their birthday. You can select the gender, and then if you're going to be doing a obstetric exam, it's really important that you put in either the LMP or you have other options here so that the ultrasound machine can accurately calculate the percentiles and can give you the details on the growth charts when you do that. So once you're happy with all of that, you just hit tick. If you're using the ultrasound machine in a radiology practice, you might need to change the accession number, and you might need to put in details such as the operator or the performing or referring physician. And once you've entered these details once, so for example, if we do the performing physician, once we enter it once and save it, it'll then appear in the drop-down box by pressing the arrow. You can access that. So if we want to, we're just going to hit tick and we'll be able to start our first scan. At the bottom of the screen, you should see the patient's details and the new patient ID as well.